This is a press conference by Minister Motegi.
大臣、お願いいたします。
From my part, I have several points to report to you. First of all, between the future relationship negotiation between the EU and the UK, I have already issued a statement as a foreign minister, but briefly, on the 24th of December, the EU and the UK government announced the conclusion of the negotiations on the EU-UK future relationship. The government of Japan welcomes the introduction of tariffs between the EU and UK has been averted. And we hope that the EU and the UK will swiftly take necessary measures, including the approval of respective parliaments. The government of Japan remains committed to further strengthening relationship with the EU and UK based on the economic partnership agreements and also for the smooth operations of Japanese companies. We will closely monitor the implementation of the agreement on the future relationship going forward. The second point, when the new year comes, I am going to make overseas visit. From the 4th of January to 14th, I'll be visiting Mexico, Uruguay, Argentina, Paraguay, Brazil, 5 countries in Latin America, in addition, Senegal, Nigeria, and Kenya in Africa. In total, I'll be visiting 8 countries. Since the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic, this is going to be the first visit by a Japanese minister to Latin America and second visit to Africa. In all the countries I will be visiting, the strengthening of the bilateral relationship, and also I would like to confirm cooperation toward a free and open Indo-Pacific, and also I want to advance diplomacy with both tolerance and strength. Further, among countries I visit, particularly Nigeria, on the 24th yesterday, African CDC announced that detection of a new variant of coronavirus in the country. However, this new variant in summer and October, the new variant has been already detected at that time, according to the report. So I will make my final judgment based on the infectivity of this variant and also the prevalence situation. I will make a final decision regarding Nigeria later on. In the Latin America, I will exchange views with countries that Japan shares basic values to advance cooperation to maintain and strengthen free and open international order based on the rule of law and deepen economic relationship, including improvement of business environment for Japanese companies. Also, in Latin America, there are many Japanese people living, so I would like to strengthen cooperation with Japanese communities there. Regarding Africa, I visited some countries already in the first half of this month. Therefore, building upon that achievement, I want to confirm cooperation with countries toward TICAD 8, including issues of development, regional peace and stability, and business relationship.
The third point is about appointment of an ambassador. Based on our cabinet decision this morning, as of today, Tomita Koji, Japanese ambassador to South Korea, is newly appointed to the new Japanese ambassador to the United States. Ambassador Tomita has experienced positions like the Director General of the North American Affairs Bureau and Minister of the Japanese Embassy in the U.S. He has strong relations developed with the United States. The new Biden administration will start on the 20th of January, so we hope there will be close relations with the new administration and further strengthen Japan-US alliance and cooperate to realize the free and open Indo-Pacific and also to promote rulemaking post-COVID. I hope he will make use of his experience and personal relations going forward. The last point is about passports, indication of other surnames. To indicate the former surname in a passport, until now there are very strict requirements to allow it. But for applications made after the 1st of April next year, the requirements will be relaxed, and the method of writing on the passport will be changed. To be specific, based on family register copy and a resident card with a former surname indicated, or my number card. If a former surname can be confirmed through these documents, it is possible to write the former surname together with the formal surname. Until now, the former surname was in parentheses, but the meaning of parentheses was not clear. So in the status page of the passport, to make it easy to understand for the foreign immigration officers that is a former surname, it will be explained. There will be explanatory note in English writing former surname. And also in cases of international marriages, if there is a different surname besides a former surname, if a required requirements are satisfied, that surname will be allowed to be indicated. So an explanatory note saying alternative surname will be added. With this change, we hope that it will be possible to have a smoother travel abroad and activities abroad. This concludes my presentation. Thank you. Any questions? If you have any questions, please use the microphone stand and mention your name and affiliation. Any questions? Yes, NHK, Mr. Yamamoto. Yamamoto from NHK. About the negotiations between the UK and EU. After Brexit, from the economic circles, there are concerns about impact to Japanese companies. On the 1st of January, between Japan and the UK, EPA will come into effect. So the EU-UK negotiations was agreed upon. So what will be the impact? Is it possible to minimize the impact of Japanese companies? And on the other hand, are there any other issues?
I don't think there is a major issues remaining. But the EU, the UK is existing from the EU. In such a situation, between Japan and the UK, continued business relationship has to be maintained. For that purpose, we have a Japan-UK EPA. We signed the EPA, and that has been already approved by the Parliament. From January next year, this EPA will take effect. So remaining issue was such that relationship between the UK and EU, what would be the new relationship or agreement between the two parties? So the Japanese companies which are operating in Europe, which were using global supply chain, so this issue may affect their activities. Therefore, Japan, has been urging EU and the UK to seal this deal as quickly as possible. After hard work, fishing issue has been solved, finally. So going forward, the UK and EU, both parties, we have to go through domestic procedures. I hope that this procedure will be made swiftly. So basically, Japan and Europe and among Europe, particularly Europe and UK, we have a Japan-EU EPA. In the past, we had the EPA. That kind of activities will be maintained thanks to this new agreement. We are going to closely monitor the situation. If there is a problem, we are going to take measures such as raising issue to relevant countries going forward. Asahi Shimbun Sato-san, please. Asahi Shimbun Sato is my name. Changing the subject, I want to ask about the relationship between the US and Japan. According to the report today, you were interviewed. You talked about your visit to the United States within 1 or 2 months after the inauguration of Biden administration on the 20th of January. What is your view regarding the timing of your visit?
Yes, the new administration in the United States at the moment has not yet been inaugurated, but after the new administration is inaugurated, the new State Secretary Blinken when he is formally appointed. I hope I can see him as soon as possible. And of course, the new administration, after inaugurated, it depends on their status of preparation, and also the COVID-19 situation should also be considered. But as soon as possible, well, usually this would mean in 1 or 2 months. So we will take this into consideration to make coordination about the schedule. Next question, please. Powering news.
From Japan. My question is about the Middle East, as usual. There have been press reports that GCC of Gulf Cooperation Council summit will be held in January 5th. And there are also some reports that the Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Nawaf, mentioned the achievement of reaching a deal, final agreement to resolve the Gulf crisis between these countries. What is Japan's view on this issue, given Tokyo's close relations with GCC countries and the importance of providing each other with energy security and market security? Thank you.
First of all, regarding energy security that you mentioned, actually, we rely on the Middle East for 90% or so of crude oil imports. For such a country like Japan, peace and stability in the Middle East is extremely important. So for this reason, I sincerely hope that the relationship among Gulf states will be improved. Now, GCC summit, the cutting off diplomatic relationship with Qatar may be discussed, according to the press report. Regarding this diplomatic relationship issue, I understand that the government of Kuwait has made an announcement that a final agreement was reached for the resolution of this issue. Therefore, very positive development can be seen, in my view. Government of Japan appreciates highly the efforts made by Kuwait and other relevant countries. I sincerely hope that will lead to the resolution of this issue going forward. Kyodo Press, Nakano-san. Kyodo News. Kyodo News, Nakano is my name. In 2015, the comfort woman issue is something I would like to ask you. The 5 years have passed on the 28th next week. And how do you assess the efforts made by the Korean side for the past 5 years?
日韓合意に関する日韓合意、これは日韓両政府が
Well, the comfort women issue is a result of diplomatic efforts between the two countries at the ministers meeting, foreign ministers meeting of the 12th on December 2015. We're able to reach a final and irreversible solution. So immediately after the foreign minister's meeting, there were confirmations made by the leaders, and I understand commitment was made by the Korean government, even if a government administration changes. That is a commitment between countries. Japan-ROK agreement must be put into practice with responsibility. And for this agreement, including the United States, the international community is highly evaluating this agreement. So steady implementation of the agreement is a responsibility not only of Japan, but also a responsibility of South Korea to the international community. So this is a commitment made between the agreement between the two countries, and Japan has implemented all of the agreement. International community is watching the implementation of agreement by the Korean side, so we will continue to strongly request the Korean side to implement the agreement. Next question, please. Sankei Shimbun. This is Yoshinabe from Sankei Shimbun. On the 23rd, a diplomatic record was made public. In 1989, after the Tiananmen event, Western countries were considering a joint sanction, but Japan was opposing that. And after that, China did not show any changes that Japan expected. Even now, there are serious cases of human rights in Hong Kong and Uyghur. So what are your views as a foreign minister? And in addition to that, the current human rights issue of China, how do you think we should approach?
First of all, the basic premise is that the declassification of diplomatic records is such that we are to leave the past diplomatic activities of the Japanese government to historic validation. Therefore, the significance of each and every record declassified has to be left to historians for judgment. So based on that, I would like to say the following. With regard to Tiananmen Square incident, right after the incident, that is 1989, June 5th, Chief Cabinet Secretary issued a statement. A statement says the use of the military force led to a clash causing a loss of many lives. This is a very tragic and painful. It is highly regrettable. So that is our view. So the government of Japan considers the freedom, fundamental human rights, and the rule of law. They are the universal values for international society. Therefore, this should be guaranteed even in China as well. Nikkei, Kato-san. Kato of Nikkei. With regard to border control, last month in the UK, new variant of COVID-19 was detected, and therefore the government has decided to stop new entry of foreigners from UK. However, recently, the new variant was detected in Germany and, as you said, in Nigeria recently as well. Therefore, going forward, suspension of entry permission, or how are you going to strengthen border control going forward?
On the 21st of December, according to WHO report, including South Africa, seven countries, the UK, Australia, Denmark, Italy, Iceland, Netherlands, and South Africa. In these countries, a new variant was confirmed. And first, according to press reports, in Hong Kong, Singapore, Germany, and Nigeria also, the same variant was also confirmed. And on the 18th of December, the South African Department of Health has indicated that in the same country, the cause of expansion of infection is the variant that was found in many places. So under such a situation about international traffic of people, Japan currently, for countries and regions of level 3 in terms of infectious disease risk information, unless there is special reason, in principle, immigration is banned. And also for 11 to countries and regions, we are taking measures by suspending the visa exemption. And based on the issue of a new variant, on the 23rd of December, the government decided to strengthen the border measures against the UK. So meanwhile, new foreigners' immigration into Japan from UK will be rejected, and also Japanese travelers to the UK after returning, there will be no relaxation of the requirement to be quarantined for 14 days, and also we will request a test certificate within 72 hours before leaving the country from the UK, and also for we'll ask Japanese to refrain from traveling to the UK. Currently in the UK, the new variant is spreading quite a lot. And as I have mentioned, what is the situation in other countries should also be considered. So to prevent expansion of infection in Japan, depending on the circumstances, similar or necessary measures could be taken. Any other questions? If not, this concludes today's press conference. Thank you very much.